Hi, I'm Dr. Mike Evans. Usually I'm talking about the science behind best health, but today I want to start a movement. A movement called Let's Make Our Day Harder. I know that sounds counterintuitive. In fact, usually I'm asking, how can I make it easier to do the right thing? But let me explain. A recent review in JAMA Internal Medicine compared the health of baby boomers to previous generations. It showed what you might expect. Medical advances have led to longer life expectancies. But it also shows something else. U.S. baby boomers have more chronic disease, more obesity, and lower self-rated health than members of the previous generation at the same age, even though we smoke less and work out more than the Mad Men generation. So what's the difference? Well, I think for a variety of reasons that include technology, culture, and attitudes, we have a severe generational case of sitting disease. We watch phones, tablets, and TVs. We stare at computers while we work and pride ourselves on not moving for 4 hours straight. We don't walk to a friend's house or a coworker's office. We text them. I text my kids in my own house. Don't get me wrong, I love technology. There's lots of good to be had, but I also think we need to be mindful that as technology becomes more ubiquitous, it can loot the medicine chest of our single best treatment for good health, being active, moving. We shop on the internet instead of walking to the store. We have vacuums that automatically circulate so we don't have to. Electric toothbrushes so we don't have to move our hands up and down. With the push of a button, we can manipulate the TV, the music, the temperature. We might even choose our house based on these conveniences or on the size of the TV room or garage, not walkability. Living further away gets you a bigger house, but it can also mean another half hour a day of sitting in your car. To compare ourselves to the recent low-tech, simpler past, let's look at the Amish. The average Amish dude walks 18,000 steps a day. The average Amish woman, 15,000. American men walk 7,200 steps a day and women 5,200. In Canada, we're a bit better, and I actually find these numbers a bit high, but 2009 data show 9,500 steps per day for men and 8,400 for women. Unfortunately, this drops by about 1,500 steps a day once we hit 60. I think it's time to change our prevailing attitude. Maybe easier isn't really better after all. So how's about you and I start a movement, an anti-pushing the button so the door opens automatically for us movement. I'm not talking about extra stuff like going to the gym or running. If you do that, it's great. I'm talking about the health gold of our daily habits, what I call tweak the week. It's about looking at your week and seeing where you can make it harder by taking the stairs or riding your bike or getting off a stop early on your daily commute. Have a walking meeting instead of sitting in a conference room. I had a 90-year-old patient tell me the other day that he gets off two floors above his floor. When I asked him why, he said, well, I can't go up the stairs too well anymore, but I can still go down. Can you flip technology and use your phone or other wearable to monitor and remind you to move or stand more? How about going for a walk at lunch instead of just going somewhere else to sit? Can you reframe buying a push mower or a rake or a snow shovel as an opportunity? Instead of driving around the parking lot for 10 minutes trying to find that spot that's 10 feet closer, can you just park farther away in that spot reserved for people who want to live longer and have a higher quality of life? Let's rethink this a bit. Let's you and I and our loved ones and our coworkers and our friends, let's all mix in a little low-tech into our high-tech. Let's do something that's totally in our control. Let's make our day harder.